We started working together back in 2011. So it's now almost like 12 years. At the very beginning, we had a conceptual idea how to make things and how CSEM really helped us during this process with like several governmental InnoSwiss projects was really helping us putting low power in the RF design in our circuits such that we can demonstrate the lowest power and smallest size silicon for the automotive industry.
I think the current position of 3dB in the UWB market is a little bit particular because it's addressing only one specific part of the standard, which clearly differentiates the solution of 3dB compared to the other players in the market. And this specificity allows 3dB to have low complexity, first of all, which brings clearly an advantage to get a low cost and a low power solution. It allows 3dB to let the user keep the same experience as he had before with an unsecure solution, and allow also the car maker to keep the same ecosystem.
We faced lots of challenges. It was a process which lasted approximately 7 years in order to actually have first chips in production in a car. For a small company, it was not possible to penetrate the automotive market. So the biggest obstacle and challenge for us was to find the right partners in the automotive industry, including semiconductor, tier one, and also OEM, in order to actually create the first car with 3dB secure solution. The first car model started end of 2019. We knew that together with our partners, we have done really a good solution, but the response of the market came later when we actually received very positive feedback from the car manufacturers about our solution, and especially we actually had zero quality returns after several million chips being put on the road.
I think that the potential of, in general, ultra-wideband over the security market is huge, and if it's huge, it's also huge for 3dB solution. There is various markets where the security of distance measurement are important. Clearly, the first one is the keyless entry for automotive, but also for personal buildings or home or industry, but also for asset tracking. Thanks to the accuracy of the ultra-wideband technology to follow in a secure way some asset. And this market is expanding even more at the moment with the integration of ultra-wideband in the smartphones and tablets, which open a large market.
Now there is a new standard which is currently being developed called .4AB. It will become a reality towards the end of the year. And in that standard, we will need actually to bring new efficient ultra-wideband implementations to the market in terms of power consumption, in terms of silicon size, in terms of provable security for the ranging. So that's one important aspect which we will need to innovate and put our effort together in order to continue bringing high quality competitive products. And a second aspect which is becoming also very important is to integrate new features in the ultra-wideband technology, for example, sensing, that we're able to sense presence in a car or in an environment, or actually to see if such aspects can be well combined with the ranging function on a single chip. So I see really very interesting innovation topics for both 3dB and CSEM, and we continue collaborating together.